we determine who dies? Who determines who dies? And we've been in it, trying to apply it for all these years. Let me tell you my story. I didn't start out thinking that I'm gonna go to death row. Who? Even if you become a nun and you want to teach kids or be holy, who thinks, oh, I'm going to be a nun, I'm going to go to death row? I mean, the media, that's the one effect. What are you, a nun, doing on death row? Like I set out, you know, here's my vision of following Jesus. I'm going to death row. I mean, really. But what happens is, it's currents in a river. A river is not a flat body of water that just moves flatly. They're currents and eddies in rivers. And we get involved with people and with issues. And so, like, human rights is a current in that river. All of us assembling on this day, we're a current in a river. And for me, it was awakening that the gospel of Jesus called me to be on the side of poor people. Is it possible for us, if you think of both arms of the cross and the deep love that's got to extend in reconciliation and peace out to both sides on this issue, could we have one arm accompanying victims' families and people of violence, and the other, people in prison, the perpetrators, what's happening to them? What's going to happen to all the 2.3 million people in prison that we have put into prison? Two-thirds of them are there for nonviolent crimes, breaking up the families. What happens to people in this process of incarceration and exile and away from the human community?